Hey guys, the dude from Denmark here. Welcome to episode 6 of Gatecrash, the new expansion that's about to come out for Magic the Gathering. More spoilers have been revealed today, including new Gideon Planeswalker, so let's check him and the rest of the spoilers out. The version of Gideon is called Gideon Chairman of Justice, which costs you 4 mana to cast. He got 4 loyalty counters to start off with. His first ability gives you 1 loyalty counter. Put a loyalty counter on Gideon Chairman of Justice for each creature target opponent controls. His second ability costs you 0 loyalty counters to do. Until end of turn, Gideon Chairman of Justice become an indestructible human solar creature with power and toughness each equal to a number of loyalty counters on him. He's still a planeswalker, prevent all damage that would be dealt to him this turn. His ultimate costs you 15 loyalty counters to do. Exile all other permanents. If you look on the forums, people really seems to hate this guy and doesn't really like him at all and think he's really bad. And really think that the only good thing about him is his artwork. I don't know what I think about this guy. I think it's nice to see a planeswalker that gives you loyalty counters for the first time, I think it is. I do think he's not really my type of planeswalker, but I do think he's a good planeswalker, and that ultimate is just really sick and seems like you can get that really quick if you got an opponent that that just put out a lot of creatures really quick. So I think he's fine as he is. You're welcome to leave me a comment down below and tell me what you think of this new version of Gideon. Let's move on to Angel Skarmisha, which is a white angel which costs you 6 mana to cast. It's a 4/4 and got flying. At the beginning of each combat, choose First Strike, Vigilance or Lifelink. Creatures you control get the chosen ability until end of turn. This is a nice card, but I'm really unsure if at the beginning of each combat means that after you have declared your combat phase or just before. Because if it's just before, it kind of sucks that your opponent is gonna know if you choose First Strike, Vigilance or Lifelink for all your creatures. Because then the opponent can be more defensive this turn. So I really hope it means that it's after it declared, because then you can choose that your opponents gain, for instance, First Strike this turn, and then the opponent can't really do much about it. Biovisionary is a green and blue 2/3 human wizard creature which costs you 3 mana to cast. At the beginning of each end step, if you control 4 more creatures named Biovisionary, you win the game. This must be the most random card ever. I don't see why. What's the link to it that you just win the game? I don't know if a biovisionary is mean that you that it's automatically a win condition, but I don't know. It's really a weird creature. But I guess if you have all 4 of them, you win the game. Hey, Gruul Keyrune is an artifact which costs you 3 mana to cast. You can tap this to add either one red or one green mana to your mana pool. You can also pay one red and one green mana to let Gruul Keyrune become a 3/2 red and green beast artifact creature with trample until end of turn. Samic Guildmate is a green and blue elf wizard creature which costs you 2 mana to cast. It's a 2/2, and for 2 mana you can this turn each creature you control enters the battlefield with an additional 1/1 counter on it. You can also pay 2 mana to remove a 1/1 counter from a creature you control to draw a card. This art is really nice, and the card in general is really good and really support Evolve really good. I think it's a great card and gives you so much advantage. Of Binding is a blue sorcery spell which costs you 2 mana to cast. Tap target creature on opponent control. This creature doesn't untap during its controller's next untap step. Then it got Cypher. I'm really excited that that this card is really good with Cypher. I also thought the other cards were good with Cypher, but I really like this card, especially because when you get damage through to the player, you now can tap target creature on opponent control without paying its mana cost. So I think I really like this card. Foundry Champion is a red and white elemental soldier creature which costs you 6 mana to cast. It's a 4/4, and when Foundry Chairman enters the battlefield, it deals damage to target creature or player equal to the number of creatures you control. You can pay 1 red mana to let Foundry Chairman get +1/+0 until end of turn, or you can pay 1 white mana to let it get plus 0 plus 1 until end of turn. Main difference is a red and a green sorcery spell, which costs you 2 mana plus X. Choose one or more. Clan Difference deals X damage to target creature with flying. Clan Difference deals X damage to target creature without flying. And or Clan Difference deals X damage to target player. This is a crazy card. I mean, it does all. I mean, it gives damage to everything, and doesn't really cost you that much mana. Of course, it's X mana, so you choose yourself how much mana you want to spend on this. But I actually think it's a really cheap card. I really like this card. Skarg Goliath is a green beast creature which costs you 8 mana to cast. It's a 9/9 with trample. It got Blood Rush, where you can pay, in this case, you can pay 7 mana to discard it to target creature. Target attacking creature this turn gets +9/+9 and trample on the end of turn. This creature in general is just really awesome. 8 mana to get a 9/9 with trample isn't that much, I think. And the Blood Rush only costs you 7 mana to let a creature get +9/+9 and trample on the end of turn, target attacking creature. So I think it's a really nice card. Aberration is a black and blue horror creature which costs you 5 mana to cast. Consuming Aberration's power and toughness are each equal to the number of cards in your opponent's graveyard. Whenever you cast a spell, each opponent reveals cards from the top of his or her library until he or she reveals a land card, then puts those cards into his or her graveyard. This creature is really nice and really supports Dimir Mastermind we saw yesterday, where Dimir Mastermind could shapeshift into a creature your opponent had in your graveyard. This will become a lot more easier now this creature have whenever you cast a spell, each opponent reveals cards from the top of his or her library until he or she reveals a land card, then put those cards into his or her graveyard. So chances are you get a real nice creature into the opponent's graveyard to let the Dimir Mastermind shapeshift to. So I think those two cards works really well together. The show today is called Night Vale Spectre, which is a black and blue spectre creature which costs you 3 mana to cast. It got flying, and whenever Night Vale Spectre deals combat damage to a player, that player exiles the top card of his or her library. Then you may play cards exiled with Night Vale Spectre. This is such a nice creature, I think. I think the only problem with this creature is that since you now can play cards exiled with this creature, if you don't have the mana for it, you can't really do anything. So I think that's a bit of a problem. But in general, I really like this creature and like the idea of taking something from your opponent, just like Dimir Mastermind and other things for the Dimir Guild. So I think it's a really nice card. That was the cards I wanted to show today. You can leave me a comment down below and tell me what you think of the cards we have seen so far and Gatecrash in general. If you want, you can subscribe to me to follow more of my videos. Whenever there are new spoilers coming out, I will be making a new video. So if you're interested in that, you can subscribe. Until next time, have fun, guys.